If you are here and you click the video, you are in the perfect spot. Is Turo still worth it in 2022? Well, before I answer your question, let me introduce you to myself. My name is Elvis. For those of you guys who don't know, I've been doing Turo for about a year and a half now. I started with one car. I own five cars under my profile. I got three that's financed, one that I lease, and one I co-host. And it's been a very good journey. It's not like one of those business you get rich quick overnight. If you coming in here on this pace and you're expecting to get rich overnight, let me tell you, this is not the business for you. And I don't think there's any business out there that will get you rich overnight. And that being said, you have to put work into it. It's a legit business. You have to meet customers, hand them the keys, clean the cars. You have to do some finances at the end of the month. You have to do some numbers. It's a legit business. And the way I started Turo was, I started Turo with one car, and an opportunity came, showed up, basically. It was a promotion. I saw the opportunity there, and I was like, this is a perfect opportunity. I got my first booking. I was very excited for that. It was my first time. I saw how much I was gonna make and everything. I was like, damn, if I can do this with one car, I can basically multiply. I was basically about to jump all in. I was about to go get like 5-7 cars to just jump on board. But I was like, after watching so many YouTube videos, I was like, damn, I gotta really slow down and just take it one by one. So I started one car. After a month later, that car did very well. It was a 2017 Ford Fusion. That was my first car I started with. Ever since, so every month after that, I started to get one car after another. And that's where I'm today. Well, let's talk about, how do you get started, right? Well, first of all, what is Turo? Turo is basically like the Airbnb of cars. You know, like if you go on vacation, you're looking for a place to stay, you go get Airbnb. Same with cars. Turo is basically the same thing as Airbnb, where people rent out their cars and they make money out of it, you know, whatever you want to do with it. First of all, for you to get started on Turo, obviously you need a car. You need to get a car. And how do you get a car? Well, first, there's probably multiple ways you can go about getting a car. You can go finance a car, you can buy the car straight out, you can lease a car. I know a lot of hosts lease a car. The downside of leasing a car is you don't know how many miles you're gonna put into the car. You can put anywhere from 20, 30, 40K a year on mileage on that car, and depending on your contract, it is pretty hard to manage the mileage. To recommend you start off financing a car, and if you do have the capital and the cash, go ahead and go get yourself a car. Like with every business, it has risks. I tell people this all the time. What's the worst thing that can possibly happen is somebody crashes the car. But if somebody decides to crash the car and wreck the car on an accident, don't worry, you are covered. As long as you follow all the guidelines, you took a bunch of pictures, pre-trip pictures, you should be good. Best way for me, I think, if you have the capital to get a car, is go and get a car. If you do not have the capital to buy a car, what you can do is you can finance a car. Depending on your credit score, you can finance and do the down payment. That's all on you. I cannot tell you how much you gotta put down because I don't know your situation. Tip and advice right now, if you are not getting enough bookings and your car has just been sitting there not getting bookings, is because either you have the price too high, you do not offer like deliveries, your time, and basically you want to expand your availability with the car also, because most people, if you work during the day and you can only do pickups during the morning or in the afternoon, that's a big downside. So me, I do 24 hours. So guests can arrange 24 hours. They can do pickup, which is a big plus, big advantage to get you those bookings. Also, I try to see what my car is going for. Like, I check Hertz, Enterprise. I do my homework. Like, what are the daily prices of those cars? Because, like, I don't just depend on Turo for the automatic pricing and stuff like that. And you don't want to just guess and be like, yeah, I just want to put my car on the platform for $100 a day, and while Hertz and Enterprise has it for like $38 a day. Do your homework before you set the price. A lot of people ask, okay, which car should I get? Now, this all depends where are you at. Now, like, I live in Massachusetts and we get shit tons of snow over here. I'm not gonna get a rear wheel drive. That is a no in my market. It's not gonna do well. If you get a Mustang, a Camaro, anything that's rear wheel drive, basically, I would not recommend, because it's just not gonna do as well, and it's just gonna do terrible in the winter time. So what cars is good in your market? Well, I can't tell you that because I'm not in your market, so you have to find out for yourself. If you like live down in Florida, something like that, California, in the warm climates, yes, a Mustang, a rear wheel drive car is fine. But depending on where you are, if there's a lot of tourists, you gotta take into consideration the vehicles that you buy. Like, are there a lot of families coming in for vacation? Is where I live a good place where the family comes in? If that's a yes, then the best thing to do is get a bigger vehicle that can accommodate those people. And that's how you know which car you should get. It all depends on you. Like, do you want to start with luxury cars? Do you want to start with, like, do you want to start with economy cars? Like, do you want to have your fleet all being all foreigns, Mercedes, Germans, all Japanese? That is all on your preference, and you have to do your research for that. My advice for somebody new who's trying to start tour and they don't know which cars to get, my best advice is to do your homework. If I live in somewhere like Miami, where I have a lot of tourists trying to flex their money, yes, getting sports cars down there and coupes and rear wheel drive makes sense, because you have the market, you have those people who are willing to rent the car. If I live somewhere in Massachusetts, like, I'm not gonna get a rear wheel drive car, especially during the winter. Like, that's a big no-no. My car is not gonna be able to handle the snow, first of all. It's not gonna get rented on Turo in general. So there is no point for you to do that. So do your research before you actually go and find the type of cars you want to put into your profile. Okay, and to answer the question, is Turo still worth it in 2022 for somebody like trying to get a car right now with the interest rate pretty high, inflation going on? Is it still worth it? I'm not anyway a financial advisor, or this is my personal opinion and this is what I would do. Definitely take into consideration and how much money will I be making with this car before I go and purchase the car. Interest rate could be high, but the profit margin can still be there. And if you decided to still go and purchase that vehicle, you could refinance that vehicle later on once the interest rate hopefully goes down. So it all depends on you and your financial situation right now. If you have the capital to go and buy the car, then that is up to you to do that. But for me, is it still worth it? Yes, it's still worth of doing in 2022. I'm still getting booked. I'm still getting trips after trips. If you guys got any knowledge, any information out of this video, hit that like. Don't forget to subscribe. If you guys have any questions, drop it down below in the comment. I'll be happy to answer any questions you guys have. Just drop them in the comment down below. Let me know in the description what you guys think about this video. I know I didn't cover every single detail to detail information on how to get started. This is a general idea for the people who's trying to get into the business. Don't forget to subscribe. Hit that like button. We'll be back with another video. Let's get this Wi-Fi money all 2022 and beyond. Let's get it. I'm like a 9-to-5 job that you work for me. I'm your getaway.